The Koestler Trust tries to encourage participation in the arts across lots of different art forms. We take artwork for the annual awards from not just prisons, but also immigration removal centres, secure children's homes, young offenders institutions, secure hospitals, and from people on probation. We try and encourage people to take part, whether it's for their own kind of rehabilitation and to kind of work through problems that they've got and to kind of get their thoughts onto paper, whether that's writing or an artwork. We also try and encourage people to produce artwork in order to feel good about themselves and to get a sense of achievement. In July we met the curators, seven people from different backgrounds, different areas of interest, different walks of life, who'd all suffered because of a crime committed against them. When they came in the very, very first day, right at the beginning of the project, I think they were probably quite bombarded with the thousands and thousands of artwork that we had at Koestler.
Is that right?
We
only get 25?
I believe so. Yeah, between us.
Yes, it has been.
Because there's only 100 and something that 50, we're allowed
150. Yeah. Well, I think I've picked at least 40, and I think there's 150 to go in the exhibition.
But through going to speak to various people in the arts, seeing exhibitions, seeing how different exhibitions had been put together, how different works had been chosen, I think they were able to slowly whittle it down and look at the artwork in different ways.
The fact that this painting was done by somebody who committed a crime actually didn't come into my thought pattern, because what I saw was the picture. I don't know what was going on in that person's life and in that person's mind. And yes, I've been a victim. I'm not excusing it, but what I've done is forgiven the situation that took it there. So that means when I'm looking at something, I'm not looking at it with anger. I'm not looking at it with bitterness. I'm just looking at it as an individual who has a talent and has expressed that talent. That's how I'm looking at it. So that way, I can give every piece of art a fair chance.
They've just managed to work really well together through thinking about the kind of various reasons that people might have for choosing artwork and the personal feelings that people have about certain pieces.
You tend to think of prisoners and people who've committed crime as being really dark inside themselves. And actually, this shows to me that the colours are so vibrant that actually this person has got some real good things coming out of themselves, some really good hope inside of them, some colour inside of them as well. So that kind of makes me feel good. Actually, I think that's nice.
For me, there was a lot of underlying things I hadn't really dealt with, which I'm actually quite glad I'm dealing with now. And bringing it into the exhibition as well is really showing how I felt about what happened to me and my family, and you know, how there is some good at the end of it. You know, there always is good, but we don't always see it.
Hard, isn't it? This is the last few big decisions.
Yeah. It's really difficult.
Do you want us to move it into the centre of this bit of wall?
Yes.
Absolutely. Yes. Yes. Yes.
You can't put anything else. Yeah. Really. You probably can't put anything else.
No.
I think if you put anything next to it, you're going to lose what it's about. Personally, I think it should be on its own. That's just my point.
I think we should just put that wall.
And what you say is good.
The whole wall.
Tell us again what
the reason for that
would
be.
Yeah.
So that the prison life isn't all spread out there, it's all in one area.
But there are certain areas where you can sense a real consideration to theme and to grouping works, maybe by how they look or maybe by the meanings within them. And I think that came about through the curators really grasping and really thinking about how does it work together and what does it say to the viewer. So I think they were really thinking about the audience.
Southbank Centre and the Festival Hall have always prided themselves on being a place that everybody can experience the arts, everybody can take part in the arts. That has to include offenders, ex-offenders, people who, you know, for different reasons have their liberty withheld. And I think it's an incredible thing for us to be able to mount the work of the Koestler Trust every year.
It was fantastic walking in early this morning and seeing it finished after the chaos of last night. When I left, it was still a work in progress, and now it's ready for the public. It all looks marvellous.
With the window first, we thought we'd put a circus theme to give everybody a good feeling, a happy feeling. Over the other side, we put a duck, a hoop duck, another circus theme, so people see that it's not going to be heavy prison stuff. So like prisoners, they have all the fun time outside, and then when they get inside, the door shuts down. And then when they come out again, the other end, the fun time starts again.
The opening of this year's exhibition included performances by Hip Hop Shakespeare, Dance United and Jail Guitar Doors.
I do just want to say a word of particular thanks to Victim Support, who were the first people we made contact with when the idea emerged of asking victims to curate this exhibition.
If offenders are presented with the impact of their crime, that human cost, if you like, they may begin to see things differently. And for some, this is the turning point of stopping offenders.
Might I just take a moment to applaud the artists and curators for what, yet again, is an absolutely fantastic exhibition.
This can only help promote the potential for positive achievement and transformation through the arts to the benefit not only of the offender, but to society as a whole.
Different, different, it's a lifetime, yeah? Fresh for the new year, old ten, sitting in my jail, so remembering the young days. Everything's changed. Everything's changed. Nothing ain't how it was, nothing ain't the same. Trying to remember back then before I had the name. All the innocence gone from my young days. Everything's changed. Nothing ain't how it was, nothing ain't the same. Trying to remember back then before I had the name. All the innocence gone from my young days.
I think it was Western philosophy I was reading. There was a title, or basically a line in the book I was reading called Emptiness Does Not Exist. It gave me the idea for this work, basically a brain speeding through space. So basically saying that the human brain can find emptiness, it does exist, because we can find that in our own solitude. And obviously prison being a place of solitude was where I felt I was.
Fair enough, I'd been in trouble and got the sentence that I got, but it was just like, all right, let's do it and go home and leave it behind. And seeing people go in and out, I just couldn't understand why until I sat down and spoke to them.
It wouldn't bother me if I come back.
Once you're in the system, it's so hard to get out. I think prison is just like a boarding school.
I'm scared of coming out.
Not everyone has the same kind of life. Everyone comes from different backgrounds, and for some people, being in prison was a sense of security.
Said you never left my side. Said you never made me cry. You looked me in my eyes, told me everything will be just fine. I guess you never let me down. Show me the meaning of true love. Stuck by your word and do everything that you said you would. My world revolves around you. Don't don't see my life without you. You're everything I live for, and the only thing that I choose to die for. So please don't change, cause I love you just the way you are.
It is amazing when you see this exhibition and the range of the work to truly understand what it's like when an artist, professional or non-professional, sets about to make a piece of creative work. And particularly in this context, when you're talking about artists who may have never made something that is personal, creative, not destructive, positive expression of who they are, not a negative expression of who they are, something highly disciplined with a great amount of personal choice in, and something which then has all the terror of revealing that to a public. And there is a terror involved in exposing something that's been done privately and giving it to others to scrutinize and critique. That's an act of bravery. And that journey of making art is something which all humans have the capacity to do, and all humans have the right to do.
Inside, it's too much pressure, it's too much pride, and you tell yourself you make an art of self-denial, but you're losing face, oh, you're losing the race, and oh, the weight of all this world will crush you down. Burning, it's your final warning. And oh, the weight of all this world will crush you down in the cold light of morning. It's your final warning.
It's helped me personally just to be a sort of more focused, considerate, thoughtful person, and to listen to other people more. So the whole curating process was incredibly valuable for me. It was like 2 years of therapy crammed into one.
It's important for the inmates and all to give them a bit of pride in themselves, you know, to see the artwork being displayed. Maybe they can't come here, but we know that they will see it. Now maybe it will stop them reoffending again, and that's what we hope, that they will change their lives.
The recognition was the best part of it, to see that people recognise that something I've done, there is life after the death.
If the exhibition gives someone a sense of forgiveness in their heart to understand the other side of crime, then that's got to be a positive, wonderful thing, because that means you can move on. We all have issues in our lives where we have to deal with unforgiveness, whether it be our friends, family, whatever, wherever it comes from. We all have those issues. But when we begin to let go, it's like stopping drinking the poison, the glass of poison. Yeah, you stop drinking it once you let it go and decide to move on. And that's wonderful. That's truly liberating for everybody, for both sides.
Leave your bridges burning. It's your final warning.